Sports can be a lot of things. It can provide entertainment. It can provide social commentary. It can provide an outlet for expression. And sometimes in the world of high school sports, it can provide even more than that. It can provide an opportunity for teenagers to be about something more than the game, more than themselves. A unique opportunity, a game between Ledyard High School and Fitch High School, is going to see a wave of purple.
So tomorrow's a big game, obviously more than just soccer. We're playing tomorrow to help raise money for Alzheimer research, which is obviously a terrible disease that affects loads of people.
I know that Alzheimer's is a mental disorder that affects many people, and not only the person that it affects, like, individually, but also their family members and their surrounding family. It's very difficult for them. So the money from this event will help support families as well as individuals.
My grandfather, we call him Papa, he's affected by Alzheimer's, so it means a lot to me that we're doing this. It's pretty cool.
My grandfather has Alzheimer's, and my mom is a clinical trial worker, so she helps to try and find a cure for this disease that there is no cure for, as we know right now.
It's affected my family personally. My father-in-law, he passed from it. He was always with my kids. He was the first one to kick a soccer ball with them besides me, throw a baseball to him, and unfortunately he never got that opportunity to actually see him play a game.
Your mom works at Pfizer, and you talk about the research and development for the cure for Alzheimer's.
Yeah, she worked on one of the first Alzheimer's drugs that are launched in the U.S., and like she tells me about all the benefit that happens, all the family it helps.
Special jersey for tomorrow. I see the normal blue of Ledyard has changed to the Alzheimer's purple.
Yeah, we've had a whole lot of people like asking if we can buy these jerseys and whatnot, and we were like, we're selling shirts and stuff. We've been promoting the game a lot, so it should be fun.
You know, tomorrow we're going to put the blue and white aside and go with the purple and white. But they know it's a big game for us, you know, sitting at 6-1 against Fitch, who's throw the records out the door. And whenever we play Fitch, the games are always very competitive, usually one-goal games. So they understand that, you know, it's a big game, but I think they also see that, you know, Pequannock Plains is going to be packed with people tomorrow. There's youth games going on.
The community is really bonded around us. We got the Groton Soccer Club coming out tomorrow. They're going to run lines for us. We got a couple of small-sided games to start the day off. We got the girls' soccer team involved trying to help get some donations with some food items, passing the bucket, passing the hat. We got a website created for this game, Kick for the Cure. It's done very well so far, and we're hoping to get more money to hopefully end this awful disease.
It's a really cool thing to experience, and it brings something more out of soccer. It's more than just soccer, and it brings communities together, and I think that's a really great thing that we're doing.
A literally awesome event for high school boys to be about something much bigger than themselves. For many, they share personal stories, they share personal experiences with this terrible disease. For others, they know that they're helping people, but they don't know exactly how. Well, guys, I'm an Alzheimer's family. My grandmother, Roberta Vendetto, my godmother, Betty Gear, and my aunt, Nellie Cormier, all died from this awful disease. So you're playing for me, you're playing for my family, and you're playing for dozens of families in your community affected by this. Thank you, boys.